That was sneaky. Crack. That should finish this. There we go. Hey, maybe a half inch will work once in a while. Oh. Man, they know I can't resist. Let's heal up the party. So let's also change the lineup a little. Are you fucking serious? Okay, so, you know, for a while, I was able to keep my ringer off for a good long time because. Who's calling me, right? Well, unfortunately, when I'm dealing with all these people I'm trying to get a job with, kind of means I got to keep the ringer on. And unfortunately, I now have to get spam calls again. So, just more grumbling from me. Feel free to ignore that. Okay. Oh. What up, Trogdor? Yeah, let's put him back in front. Shade's not going to be great here. Let's take... Whoops. Let's take him. Let's not be cowards. Oh, great. Dragon. Protection from breath attack sounds really good right about now. And... he'll do him of fire. I'm guessing dragon breathing fire. No kidding, huh? And then kabuff. And speed up. roll to parallax. See if I can paralyze this thing. Probably not. Oops. We'll do more heal for Rab. So he only seems to be pulling one attack a turn, which is kind of a relief, to be honest. Nice. Catching him off guard in the first round, I think that made all the difference in the world. So give me time to put defenses up, and Mr. Ooh, look at me, I have a breath weapon. Isn't going to be doing a whole heck of a lot. Palace of Malice. Oh, I love it. It's so fucking corny. So there's a teleporter I can't reach. And same over here. Oh, he big. I think that's the same model as Dingus. Or Indingus, whatever his name was. Just palette swapped. Huh. Oh, they're not leaving their posts. Interesting. How about... still standing. Oh, he's under one quarter. There we go. Jeez. first things first, let's try to keep her in the fight. And Hendrik, let's use Parallax, since it seems to do a ton of damage.
Nice.
Okay, and with Serena and not Erdrick pepped up, I can at least start this next fight with Care Prayer in operation.
Oh shit, he don't care.
Still, he is huge. Oh. Big happy slime. Hey, buddy. No. Lost leader. At least he's hanging around. Let's get Divide up. Good, he attacked. Alright, here we go with the doppelgangers. Only 5 damage. Bit of bad luck, I guess. Those things are just so flighty. I mean, it's the design, but man, it does get frustrating. Okay, so this should be another room with a seal in it. Yep. Okay, so... let's steal someone's ride again. Cool. Well, at least half inch works now. Oh, and they confused my main character. Oh yeah, they don't have that many hit points, do they? Okay. Well. So we're an hour and 45 minutes in. And it's been mostly this fortress. Oh. Ah, I see. So I guess lost leaders are just common enemies. Oh, let's not hit the exterior just yet. Oh hey, it's a room full of goo. And I cannot jump into it. Alright, so this is... Ah, the scary platform activator. Well then. Okay, so he looks like he's blocking the well, not quite. Where'd Trash Can go? A poker. Okay, just getting a bit of a cramp there. So let's go down and around and see if I can reach the other side. See what the platform there does. So I'm assuming this takes me back to... Yeah. So where's this one go? Oh, I bet this... I bet when I hit this, it'll take me to somewhere that'll activate the other part of whatever crossed that room in the north. Thank you. Okay, now we've got a great dragon just wandering about. Let's see. Go to the right first. Of course there's a chest. Stardust sword. Okay, here we go. All right, so that's the next section. All opened up. Oh, so that's going to be two more things to activate. I see. But now with the path cleared up to here, I can just hop on a little dragon thingy, get all the way up here, and this will be pretty much a clear path with few, if any, monsters to worry about. Yeah, I mean, I'll have to do something about these guys. One at a time. Jeez, it's a nice attack. Ooh. Jeez. Don't like desperate attacks. Now let's get the old shields up and come on, Trogdor. Enough. Nice. That's just embarrassing.
Who else wants some?
So, long time ago, playing D&D, and we had this sleeping dragon we were going to kill, and we figured, well, we got to start by doing as much as damage as possible to it. And, oh, one of my friends had an ability called kinetic control, which is a ridiculous psionic power. He could only sustain it for a few turns. And what it did was every time you took damage, at least from a physical impact of some kind, you'd be able to use that in an attack to to make an attack. So if you'd done like 50 damage to him, he could direct that 50 damage at somebody else in an attack. So we did the sensible thing, and we beat on him for a few minutes well, he maintained this, so he had a huge bonus to his attack. And we were positioned right at this dragon's eye. We've given him a massive damage bonus, and because he's not dodging or anything, it went up a little bit. And you know what? I am going to zoom out of here and come back, because I can just come right back up here and make a dash right into the Palace of Malice, and we'll see what's in there. Anyway, so Matt's saying, okay, you guys get double damage or whatever for the attack. I'm like, okay, great. Well, our friend with the ability also rolls critical. So we do just hundreds of damage to this thing directed at its eye. And we figure it just died on the spot. It was absolutely absurd. And it might be my favorite way to ever kill a dragon. The joke was, the last thing that went through that thing's mind must have been, ow, my eye. And somebody pointed out, no, the last thing that went through his mind was probably Andy's spear. But